What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Number 5.
Despite all I've put him through, I can't stay mad at Justin Bieber because, judging only by the content of his lyrics, he sounds like a pretty nice guy. The same cannot be said of Cher Lloyd, partly because, well, she's a she. And partly because she comes across as a scumbag.
For the uninitiated, she made her debut on Series 7 of the UK's X Factor, getting eliminated at 4th place. She then went on to record Swagger Jagger, which I consider one of the worst songs of 2011 that didn't make Billboard's year-end chart. Yeah, it sucks on toast with a side order of blow, but even though it debuted at number 1 in her native Britain, it failed to chart in America, thank God. So now she's back with a vengeance, starring in the breakup song Want You Back. And having taken the role of the dumpy, as it were, she is not taking it well. Boy, you can say anything you want. I don't give a shit. No one else can have you. I want you back. I want you back. Want you back.
Remember all the things that you and I did first. And now you're doing them with her. She says that like, you can't do that with her. You already did that with me. What are you, 4 years old? Or how about this gem from the bridge? I thought you'd still be mine when I kissed you goodbye.
And you might be with her. Newsflash, having a significant other before he or she takes on anyone else does not count for squat. Remember the last time I complained about a lack of perspective after a breakup? This is even worse. And while we're on the subject of Justin Bieber, she's also doing the not really cursing thing during the chorus.
If I haven't already made it abundantly clear, listening to the song hurt so much, you'd swear it was me making all those grunting noises in the background. Next! What doesn't kill you makes you
stronger. Stand a little taller. Number 4.
For those of you who haven't been on Twitter once over the past 12 months, YOLO is an acronym for You Only Live Once. Sounds like a strong message, eh? When we die, we lose all our chances of doing the things we've always wanted to. Yeah, try telling that to all the wasteoid fans who've co-opted YOLO as an excuse to shirk responsibility and do all those crazy stunts that will foul up their lives forevermore. Now she want a photo, you already know though. Yeah. You only live once, that's the
motto. Get YOLO and we bout it every day, every day, every day. Like we sitting. But the motto didn't make this list for that reason, but for being a boring, grimy, cliched piece of glam rap. It's the same trap Rack City fell into, but at least that song didn't tease us with insight into any phenomenon. Plus, that song didn't have Lil Wayne on it. 5-7 grams in the blunt, almost drowned in the so I swam to her, but it's... Spouting out the same gross misogyny you've been giving us for the past few years is bad enough, but at least sound different from the droning flow provided to us by your co-stars. Dang it, man, you put out How to Love last year. I thought you changed. Never really had luck, couldn't never figure out how to love.
Talk stupid, off with your head. Right back at ya. Yeah, jerk. Next. What doesn't kill you makes you
stronger. Stand a little taller. On the off chance you read my blog, also titled The Strawberry Dragon Project, you may remember that I wrote a review of this song when it came out. Even though I was making videos at the time, I chose not to do one based on that, since it had been tackled by not one, but two high-profile video critics. First Mark Muse, then Todd in the Shadows. I think the three of us have covered all this song's bases, but for those of you who have yet to check out any of them, I'd be happy to sum up. Despite the fact that this is a tie-in with a movie set in 1969, the song they sampled was over a decade too old, and Pitbull's lines rely overly on bragging and lame puns with only last-minute references to the film it's supposed to be promoting.
You wish the whole world would... what? Stop listening to your music? Because I'm down with that. I'm trying to make a billion out of 15 cents. Understand, understood. And my question goes unanswered, in favor of Pitbull bragging about how awesome he thinks he is. Shouldn't have been surprised. Stop the movement. They can try if they want to. Ignorar los ladinos, sí. They can try if they want to. What? Isn't that special? 1, he laughed at his own jokes, not that you could call them jokes, 3 times in 4 lines. 2, He just rhymed an entire phrase with itself with some gratuitous Spanish to boot. Pit su escritura es perezoso. Also dubstep.
Next. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller.
Number two. When I wrote up last year's worst of list on my blog, I placed this as one of the worst songs that didn't make the year-end chart. But its momentum carried over into the beginning of 2012, and lo and behold, I'm talking about it here and now. In case you haven't heard of it, here's the chorus.
Compare the hooks of the great booty jams over time, going from Baby Got Back in 1992 to Miss New Booty in 2006 to this, and it becomes just one example in an ever-growing mound of evidence which would seem to prove that humanity is locked on an ever-dumbening path. The version which charted highest replaces one of Big Sean's verses with one by Nicki Minaj, thus providing a rather disheartening dichotomy. Whereas Big Sean is allowed to brag about topics including his sexual prowess and material value, the majority of Nicki's lines revolve around how good of a desirable sex object she is, proving once again that we may never achieve gender equality in the rap game. We're all screwed. Some pooty tang, tippy tow, tippy tay, you gon' get a
tip today. Day. You gon' get some today. Oh, what? So just because she's a woman, she's not good enough to get paid in cash? At least money can be exchanged for goods and services. Sex? Not so much. I hope. Wobbly wobble, 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 ass so fat, all just throbbing. Bad bitches, I'm your leader. Look, how many times have I told you? It's bitch bad, woman good, lady better. You misunderstood. Open in the islands of Waikiki. Kiss my ass and my anus.
But there's poop down there.
Oh, and the edited version isn't even trying. And I want all of that dance, 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 go dance,
dance. As one of the few people on this earth who still likes the swears scrubbed out of the songs I listen to, I'll admit even this is going too far. Next. What doesn't kill you makes you
stronger. Stand a little taller. Number one. As you know, in 2009, Chris Brown brutally beat up his then-girlfriend Rihanna, thus ending their relationship. They've since managed to get together, for some reason. But just because the record execs decided to bring Breezy and Riri onto a song together, doesn't mean they should have. Because as bad as Birthday Cake is on its own, the context of its performers makes it even more disgusting. It's merely a sex song, but when they let Chris Brown get away with lines like this... I can only think of one thing. You stay classy, Breezy. No, seriously, I'd like it to be classy for a change.
What the hell, man? What the actual hell?
Not that Rihanna does anything to justify the work herself, either. You keep reminding us that it's not even my birthday, but why is that important? Even better, the song sucks in two flavors. There's the version from Rihanna's album, which takes out Chris Brown's lines entirely, but is only a minute 18, and the single version with Breezy present. Evidently, the full version is so bad, it's not even available on iTunes. I've read a comment on YouTube which said that this is the song the viewer would like to get a lap dance to, but let me tell you, if they played this then, it would beat down the mood just like Chris Brown beats
me at Street Fighter. I suck at that. And to Rihanna, I'm begging you, please revise the terms of your restraining order to preclude musical collaborations with Chris Brown. So that's my list, but before I go, I'd like to present a new feature which I call the wildcard entry. Basically, it's something that I would have included on the list, but had to disqualify for whatever reason. So, after all we've been through, what could have taken the dubious honors this time around?
Fun fact, this song was going to be my pick for number one, but it didn't make the year-end charts and was thus ineligible. But as despicable as the real number one worst song was, I don't think I've ever heard a song that was this devoid of anything good.
At least one that didn't involve Soulja Boy tell him, may his career burn in hell. For example, the chorus.
To say sh- and they ain't say nothing. 100 motherfuckers can't tell me nothing. I bees in the trap, beat bees in the trap. I bees in the trap, beat bees in the trap.
Let's see. Excessive use of profanities, rhyming words with themselves, and the title phrase, bees in the trap, means nothing, either taken in context or without. To think that's only the hook, and not a very hooking one at that.
Even on her other bad songs, Nicki Minaj manages an entertaining manic performance, presenting a persona on the verge of insanity. Not so here. She seems to have lost all interest in dissing her poorly defined haters.
Right back at ya, you jerk. I can say with zero hesitation that Bees in the Trap is Nicki Minaj's worst song, rather shocking considering how many times she's set the bar in the past, and I thank you, American listeners, for keeping it at bay, relatively speaking. Next week, I'll return with the top 10 best hit songs of 2012, but until then, this is Kevin, with Ichigo, and you are the Resistance. I don't always ask for subscribers, but when I do, God bless us, everyone. Stay thirsty, my friends.